the stuff of which memories are made. Those emotional scenes heralded the end of Australia's longest-running and much-loved series, A Country Practice, the first scenes of which were shot right here in this very studio 12 years ago. We were introduced to characters who very soon became part of our families. Well, tonight, we say farewell to those friends in a special 3.5-hour celebration, A Country Practice, the final night. Present the final episode. I'll take you behind the scenes with the cast and crew for the emotional final week. And stay with us later as I invite current and past cast members to share their memories. Now the countdown begins. It's been an interesting week, which held more than a few surprises. Baby, you just ain't nothing yet.
What can go wrong?
Natural disaster. Well, what about a bushfire? Drought too slow.
The final script reading for the all-important last episode. Here, destinies are forged and futures plotted.
It's no secret that our producer is a scriptwriter, and they insisted right from the start on getting this, getting good scriptwriters writing good scripts, taking the stories seriously.
Every effort is put into making the storylines as accurate as they possibly can be, whether they're of a social, medical or veterinary nature.
While there is some latitude for drama, they do try and be technically correct. The attitude at JMP was always, if you research the story thoroughly and then you apply the drama, things will work out well.
and drama is undeniably what the final episode is all about.
But we had lots of heroics.
Well, I just think the final episodes should be
bigger than Ben-Hur.
Yeah.
Well, what about Terrence and Rosemary?
What do you do with Terrence and Rosemary?
Well, how far do we take it? Are they going to expect the wedding, or are they going to expect the wedding?
Well, I think relationship
comes
I did too.
It's totally different to what I ever imagined it was going to be. So I think there will be a few surprises for the viewers.
Okay, can I invite another rehearsal, please? Okay, standing by. Action. Action. And... Action.
If ever there was to be an episode of a country practice that had to have everything, then this was it.
All right, you all know what to do. Let's get to it, shall we?
You have doubts?
It just doesn't seem to add up, that's all.
Come for the rifle, Peter.
I need it.
Come on, Dave.
I need it.
What is it, Chris? Chess?
You know, you got a talent for getting in situations like this.
Steve! What about
Eden? I don't know.
For all concerned, the making of this last episode has been long and hard, and the strain is beginning to show.
The whole crew is starting to really feel it, and we're just really pretty tired overall. Pretty flat out this morning, as you can see. We've just had a lot to get through, a lot of scenes. Yeah, we're just plodding along and hoping to get this Mammoth episode finished.
Coming up, goofs, guest stars, and old favourites.
What's that guy bring? I'll work on it.
Every fan of a country practice undoubtedly has their own particular favourite. I know I do.
We can't trust you to do the right thing. You need looking after.
Fancy the job is.
We'll see.
Over the years, a country practice has consistently played host to some great guest stars. Tonight's program is no exception.
Action.
It's all there. Can't tell you what all this is. Oh,
Mr. S. Claus, North Pole. Yes, that's very funny, mate.
Look, I know it's a marvelous
part. One of our most distinguished producers and actors, his face immediately recognisable to any fan of Australian television drama, Charles Tingwell.
The merits of a program like Country Practice are very many. Wonderful skill levels are being developed all the time on every side of the camera. Actors, technical people, writers, directors, well, you name it. It is almost like a very specialized film course at an excellent film school just itself.
I guess it's a number of things. It's the crew, it's the production team. It's the way the whole thing runs. It's a very efficient machine, and it's like a family.
And that family just wouldn't be complete for this episode without the return of some old favourites.
Penny's back.
It's a very strange feeling coming back. I was very sad when I left the show, and I'm going through it again this time. It's wonderful seeing some old faces, some older than others. And it's just such a fantastic atmosphere, and I think the best thing is to come back and see that the fantastic feeling that was there when we were in the show still is there.
Any word on the bushfires?
Billy and Darcy should be at the lodge by now. I'm guessing they're in.
It's that atmosphere of companionship and professionalism that everyone who's worked on a country practice comments on. But there's still time for fun. Well, Maggie. Fun for some.
Maggie.
I am not going to mention your absence. The place is a shambles.
But who could deny the impact of the return of former matron Sloan? But as we all know, her bark really is much worse than her bite.
Sloan, prior. As in convictions?
Registered the new matron. Thought she's good. I like her. I'm like a very matron. Snap back into it. Not Joan, you know. Sloan went... She'll do. She's good. Yes. Like her. The others were too young, you see, for Sloane.
Initially, it was written still for Sloane, so I had to find a way to make it work for me, because I could hear Joan say the lines, which is a
problem for an actor. So I had to find other aspects of a character. Rosemary is a character that I would like to be. So I've enjoyed playing her tremendously.
Miss Lone, this is not your hospital. You do not work here. Now, I can use your help, but if you can't do as you're told, the bus queue is that away.
Meanwhile, back on location, other guest stars weren't performing quite to script.
A great big mob of merinos, mate.
But it is a country practice after all, and animals are part of the landscape, aren't they?
Don't work hard, motivation.
It's moments like these that test the patience of cast, crew and director. But they grin and bear it.
Well, it's the things that make it difficult that actually make it good.
Who locks their doors in London Valley?
All my stuff.
Of course, aside from organisational problems, working with animals, particularly those who are not yet potty trained, can bring all sorts of other little perils to the production. Yes, you've guessed it. Did you know what they say? When nature calls. Back on location, it was the end of a long day and just time to squeeze in another quick scene. And yes, another animal. But this time, let's throw in some special effects for good measure.
1959.
What could possibly go wrong?
Aren't we lost?
Are we being seen here, Johnny?
Another one, please.
Hotel. Don't they ever learn?
Yeah, we'll do one more.
Apparently not.
Billy!
What man's animal?
Perhaps George had read about the dangers of passive smoking, because to say the least, he wasn't keen on hanging around. But in the end, all was well. And it wasn't the smoke and George's lack of cooperation that caused Darcy's consternation, so much as the sight of her long-lost love. Or was it?
Pinch me, I think I'm hallucinating.
Who is it?
You'll have to wait and see. Location work takes up a large part of a typical country practice shooting schedule. This one made more complex by additional elements thrown in. What better than the threat of an out-of-control bushfire to add to the drama? It's a punishing schedule for all concerned, with script and actions learned on the run.
This wind's coming down to the south.
But if that wind swings around to the south, I don't know if we can save the town.
The hospital.
Look, just keep your head down and drive like hell, all right?
With the last episode entitled Burning Bright, it's not too surprising that fire special effects make up a large part of the action.
My imagination. Is it getting hotter?
It's getting hotter.
To add to the mix, first, throw in a lost Santa Claus.
Yeah, I'm sure I left the sleigh here.
A crazed gunman. And helicopter rescues for good measure.
Just shut up and stop complaining! In about 60 seconds, this whole place is going to be charcoal!
Mix all that together, stir in the animals, and you have the perfect recipe for high drama.
The writers tend to aim high with what they expect, and 9 times out of 10, it's difficult, but we can do it. We had some good special effects team working on the show, a great crew that knows what they're doing. It's come together looking great. But what we wanted to do was make it more of an emotional drama, I guess, and concentrate on the emotions and the characters' feelings.
Doll's gone. She's going to get a divorce. She's not coming back. I've got nothing to lose, that's right.
There's police drama, there's medical drama, there's community drama, there is comedy of a little girl who has to be removed from the hospital in an emergency situation.
We have to leave the hospital and we have to do it right now. Virginia?
What?
You didn't tell me she was armed.
Of course, a country practice has been probably most famous for its weddings, so I think everyone would be disappointed if there hadn't been a wedding. And it's the wedding to end all weddings.
Coming up, tears and laughter. The end of an era. And so the last recording day dawns. And for the last time, Shane Porteous will make that early morning journey.
I live up in the mountains, so that if I'm required to start in the studio at 7 o'clock, it means I've got to be leaving home at about 5 in the morning. Wander up to the station, get on the train, and open the script straight away, and start to go through the scenes for the day, looking at notes I've made about it with a pen in hand, which is to correct things, to ideas about the way to play things, even slight line changes and things. I'll work on that until I've worked through all the scenes we do for the day.
I'll do it.
I've been in the same job for 12 years. It's almost like a proper job.
Thank you.
And I miss the routine. The adrenaline.
You just did the makeup. I'll do the lights.
I will miss it. I'll miss the people, particularly. I'll miss the cast, the fellow cast members, particularly those that I work closely with. I'll miss a lot of the crew. Some of whom have been with us right from the pilot. And from, when we first started to make the show full-time in 1981. It's the people, that kind of bonded family thing, the relationship between cast and crew was terrific. And it's something to be tremendously proud of. Because we have created a piece of Australian television history. And to be in it right from the start is something that I'll always be proud of having done.
So, it's not until we get here, if we're running like that, it's not until we get here.
Over its 12-year record-breaking history, A Country Practice has achieved many milestones. Along with its many Writers Guild Awards and numerous Logies, A Country Practice was the recipient of the prestigious United Nations Media Peace Award, a rare distinction indeed.
Stand by, everyone. This will be a final rehearsal with smoke.
If the effort and energy being put into the making of tonight's episode is anything to go by, the best is yet to come.
Sparking up.
There can be no second takes on this scene. This is a once-only moment, with crew, cast, stunt and special effects people all working together to create one of the more spectacular scenes of tonight's episode.
And also I believe we have a fireball to go through as we first emerge.
There we go. Before we go. And action!
Rosemary!
A Country Practice has always prided itself on the quality of its production. But this does not come cheaply. For example, take the number of sets that have been built only to be destroyed.
Over the 12 years, that's worked out at approximately 400 to 450 sets, which is $4 million. And if you put that in terms that people would understand better, you're looking at 27 $150,000 homes that we've built.
Wardrobe department, rummaging through the racks here, can provide some pretty interesting statistics as well.
So, Alan, over the years there must have been a lot of changes. Do you have any idea about how many?
Oh, on a quick calculation, so I'm thinking about it last night, I'll probably 26,000 outfits all together, assuming that every actress has two legs. We've had 52,000 pairs of shoes altogether.
It's more than a Melbourne Marcos.
Certainly is.
How do you feel about the clothes that are given to you? Do you have any say in it, or is it just basically to fit the character?
Well, I mean, it's obviously got to fit the character, although they have smartened me up a little bit through the years, but I see, the floppy jumpers, and she loves her jewels, doesn't she, Alan?
Yes. Safety pin, as per usual, it's been a good luck charm for us, isn't it?
Good luck.
Yes. The safety pin?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Oh, always a safety pin on the back of the bed.
And the same coat and the same dressing gown.
They say actors are superstitious, but really, the same dressing gown for all these years?
Doesn't want to buy me a new one, you know.
Fortunately, the same can't be said when it comes to making choices of the wedding dresses used in the series. And tonight, of course, is no exception. As much care is put into the selection of the wedding gown as any young bride-to-be would want. And of course, there's always that all-important decision, the right accessories.
What that I've done on ACP was probably 2 years and 9 months of the happiest years of my career, because of the kind of show, the kind of people. Sure, you'd be able to work for other wonderful projects, but this one has been quite special.
This has been like a real second home. We spend so much time here, so much time with each other, that saying our various goodbyes to even just the furniture, it's been quite nostalgic.
And so the stage is set for the final day of recording after 12 years of a country practice. Those immediately recognisable sets are trundled in for the last time. Final lighting adjustments are made. And surely no fan could miss the irony of festive decorations being dressed into the club set. But now the moment has come for that very special final scene. Over the years, a country practice has become famous for its weddings. And so the scene is set for the wedding of the series. It will undoubtedly be something special. Well, that's that. The final chapter. And it really just remains for the creator of a country practice to perform the last duty.
It's a wrap. That's it.
So there you have it. 12 years of magnificent Australian television. I'm sure we've all been touched in one way or another by this program. I hope you've enjoyed this peek behind the scenes and this chance for an emotional farewell to people that we knew as friends. Later on, there'll be a trip down memory lane when we look back over the last 12 years. But right now, the final episode of A Country Practice.